When you go after the general calling, your specific calling will always become clear. There's a difference between calling and a career. A career is something you decide. Calling is something you discover. Calling is something is decided for you. Career is something you decide. The Bible says, whatever you do, do as unto the Lord. Bible doesn't mind you doing whatever works for you that's in line with your gifts, with your talents, with your personality, as long as it makes money, as long as it's not illegal, and as long as it's not hurting somebody. Amen? So career, many people fast and pray, God, I want to know what you want me to do in a career. Honestly, I don't think we should be praying and even fasting. Just ask the question, is it illegal? Selling dope is, so you can't answer to that question is very simple. Does it benefit other people with that career? And number three, you know, doesn't make you money, because playing video games probably doesn't make money, so you can't be doing that as a career. But a calling is not something you decide. Calling is something that God decides for you. Can somebody say amen? Career is something that is natural. Calling is supernatural. You don't need any anointing to do your calling. And you don't need anointing, you don't need any anointing to do your career. You need anointing to do your calling. In order to do your career, you need to be educated, you need to be connected, and you need to, like Ilya mentioned, you need to constantly fill your mind with knowledge. The moment you get educated, the moment you get connected, and the moment you use your gifts and sets, next thing that happens is that your career will succeed. Even if you don't have a prayer life, even if you don't have a fasting life, your career will succeed. And the same way is opposite, is that if you have a calling and you're praying, you will fulfill your calling. But if you don't, career doesn't become successful because you have a prayer life. Some of people who pray in tongues and they prophesy and everything, but they're not good in their careers because it takes more than praying in tongues to succeed in your career. Career is something that's natural. Calling is something that's supernatural. Number three, career is something that changes. Calling never changes. You can always jump from one career to another. You can start with being a manager and move on to being a CEO. You can be a police officer, a sheriff, and start business with the daycare. You can be a real estate broker, a real estate agent, and then start your own business. You can always shift. Career is fluid, based on the season, based on the economy, and based on the trends and things that make you successful in this culture. That's why many of us who went to college, we went in studying for one thing, and then by the time we finish college, we change our major three times. And that's completely normal. People say, well, I'm just undecided. No, that is normal. Career can change, and you should never be afraid to jump from one thing to another, whatever that's making you money and whatever that's helping you to become who God wired you to be. But your calling never changes. You never change. It always remains the same. Whether you're in Potiphar's house or in jail or the prime minister of Egypt, you still have the same calling. Can somebody say amen? Also, a career is something that you do for money. Calling is what you do for eternity. Career is something that you do out of your ambition. Calling is your mission. Career is your platform. Calling is your purpose. And career, I like what Brian Houston said, career is what you are paid to do. Calling is what you are made to do. Career is what you are paid to do. Calling is what you were created, or what you were born to do on this earth. Can somebody say amen? I was born for such a time as this. You were born for such a time as this. You were raised to deliver. You were called by God to be the person that you are in today, to be the light and the salt. But the career is the platform for the calling to become fruitful. If you don't have a platform, you have no place to exercise your purpose. And therefore, we go to college to build a platform. We get education so we can get a great job. We get a great job so we can get a great income. It gives us influence. It gives us connections. It gives us connections. It gives us relationships with people. And God gives us platform. When God helps us to get a platform, which we call our career, and that platform is not just to make us money. It's not just to help us develop a good retirement fund. But it's also so we can leverage that for the purpose of our calling. Can somebody say amen? Amen? Esther had a platform. Her platform was she was a queen. But the purpose for that platform was not to create a magazine to inspire little girls in Jerusalem that they can make it in life. Her goal in life wasn't to be an inspiration. Her goal was to be a salvation to her generation. See, the problem with many of us today is that what we do is we take clues from the world, and the world uses popular people, connected people, people who have thousands of followers on Instagram and Facebook, people who have a platform, people who have money, and they say this, I want to be an inspiration. In the light of eternity, being an inspiration is the dumbest, stupidest idea in the world. When people are going to hell in hand baskets and they will be there for eternity, and there you are saying, God help me to get to this level, I just want to inspire little girls. It's like giving a hot dog to a blind person walking to a cliff and patting yourself on the back that you started a charity ministry. In light of eternity, if there will be no heaven and hell, using your platform for inspiration is the best thing you can do with your life. But because there is heaven, because there is hell, because Jesus died not to inspire but to save, because of that, it becomes our priority to use our platform not to inspire but to save. The fear that we have many times is that if I begin to use my platform for salvation, I will lose my platform. Actually, you have to understand one thing. Your platform will die with you. Only your purpose will outlive you. Your platform, no matter if you're afraid to leverage your platform for Christ, and you're saying, I don't want to lose customers. And I'm not talking about that at your job, you get up and stand in front of the on the reception desk and grab a microphone and say, repent, for you will perish. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying every person you do a photo shoot with, you tell them the roadmap of salvation for 5 minutes and they say, now we're ready to do a photo shoot. I am not talking about that every client that you meet with, you ask them where they're coming from and if they go to church. But I'm saying you be fluid like water. Water doesn't need a big hole to come out of the bucket. It looks for a crack. It looks for a tiny little thing and it comes out. Many people are like rock when it comes to their purpose. They need a big opportunity. They need their client or the person they do business with to begin to cry and weep, say, my life is falling apart. And only then they'll hear the Lord say, maybe I should invite him to church. You're not a rock, you're a water. You're fluid, you look for opportunities, you create opportunities. And even if it's a small crack, you'll drip, 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 but you'll come out. That's exactly how light comes out. Light doesn't look for big curtains to be open. You open it just a little bit and the light begins to come out. Not in a full measure, but in a little bit, but it will begin to come out. God wants you to leverage your platform for your purpose. Your platform will die with you. Your purpose will outlive you. Esther, instead of just limiting her life to being an inspiration to little girls in Jerusalem who are orphans, she was challenged by Mordecai, who came to her and said, listen, Esther, you're a queen. Your platform is you good looking. Your platform, you got 27 million followers on Instagram. Your platform, you post a picture and people rave around the world. That is your platform. Esther, you're popular. Esther, you're known. Esther, you did not get here just because of your looks. God gave you these looks. And now there is a purpose for this platform. The purpose for this platform is not so that you show what your mama gave you. The purpose for this platform is that you show the world what the Father gave to the world, which is His own Son. The purpose for the platform, whether it's on social media, whether it's in your work, or whether it's in your skill set, is not just to make money. Mordecai said this, he says, if you remain silent, the platform you're afraid to lose, it's already shaky and wobbly. You're gonna lose it. But he says, but if you choose to leverage your platform and overcome the fear of losing those things that you have, he says, not only you won't lose them, you'll secure them, and the world will never know you as a queen, but it will know you as a savior. Nobody celebrates Esther as a beautiful woman today. They only celebrate her as a courageous savior.